I was trying to time my sneeze. I lost it. Darn it. I lose all my sneezes. I get too excited and then they leave me. Hello, my friends. How was your weekend? Did you see some movies? Guess what? We have some guests here today, Stephen and Patrick from the YouTube channel National Film Society. We're gonna look at your comments, so how about you put in any movie questions in the chat or life questions? Do it now. Did you do it? Okay. Did you also do something that scared you and then eat comfort food like I told you to this weekend? I did. I performed new jokes at a pretty packed show. Scary. And then I had a big old pretzel at a beer hall. Beers too. And I dipped the pretzels in a bunch of sauces. I don't know what the sauces were. I was drunk. But since it's Monday, I think that it's time we rehash what happened this weekend. Some news. Here are some things that made me go, wait, what? Number one, Disney's The Magic Kingdom is no longer dry. You can buy beer and wine inside the park now. Wait, what? You couldn't before? How were adults convinced to go before? Out of, like, love for their children? I mean, I had no idea that the only drunk people were the characters in costume. Number two, Jay Farrow is playing Barack Obama on SNL now? Wait, what? That shows you how tiring the presidency must be. If Fred Armisen is like, I'm kind of pooped on this one. It helps that they have a black man with a killer impression in the cast. That's good. Number three, the iPhone 5 is now available, but you're not actually able to get one. Wait, what? Or actually, you know, none of us are surprised that it's sold out. You know, right? But the good news is that if you don't have a job and you don't mind sleeping on the street, you can get in line right now and be one of the first to get your hands on a piece of equipment that you clearly cannot afford. Number four, Kristen Stewart and Robert Pattinson are back together. Wait, what? But after she, but she, I mean, she, and then he can't, but actually I'm glad about this, right? I mean, aren't you? Don't you want them to be together? Number five, lastly, they found snakes giving virgin births. Wait, what? Scientists or whoever like found these female pit vipers in North America just thinking up a baby, just making it, and then just putting another pit viper out in the open to give us nightmares. That's true. And that's the news. What are you guys talking about? Do you have a comment for me? Laura Lee Armstrong, first live show, watch your shows every day, but first time live, love you, Beth. Awesome, this is so great. Are you a student in Chicago? Is that what's happening? So you're able to watch live? In which case, that's a good thing. But congratulations to the live chat, and we did, you know, that's awesome. Doesn't it feel good to comment? Doesn't that feel good? Feels good for me. Okay, like I said, get your movie questions in for National Film Society, who are joining me right here in a minute after we celebrate McMayhem Monday.
Hollywood could be a dirty place. That's also what it's known for. That's why I'm trying to change that. With hand sanitizer and donuts. Some people are hungry and some people are dirty. We're just bridging the gap.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to let you know it's National Hand Sanitizer Day.
Who wants some? How about you, young lady? Smash.
And I want everyone to rub their hands together at the same time. All right, everyone, hands down, and put your hands together and rub them together. Thanks, guys.
What's up? You like my face?
What's your name? It's burberry.com/pink fingernails. Someone else could grab one, and they won't get whatever's on your hands. You guys were just going through the garbage.
See? That's how clean that guy is. I could kiss his hand. Take your bag back.
What are these?
Donuts, right?
Yeah. You probably want one, right? Hand sanitizer on you. Rub them. Tops. Like a doctor. Say I'm like a doctor. Wait.
I'm very confused too.
Let me see that. Let me see that.
Taste it.
Okay, that works. Who wants a donut and who wants to wash their hands?
See, that's denial, ladies and gentlemen. There's so many germs out there,
especially in techno stores.
The moral of the story is don't suck a man's finger unless you know that shit's clean.
We're back. I'm here. here with Patrick and Steven, the men behind the YouTube channel National Film Society. When did you start your channel?
September 12th, 2011. So it's been about a year.
A year? 1 year anniversary just happened.
We had two parties.
Two parties.
Yeah, one in LA and one here in New York.
Is that why you're in New York? Because you're like, so you could have another party? Have a bi-coastal?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. We got another party, we should go to New York. And then be on this show too.
That's what we said.
I'm really glad you're here.
So are we.
Thanks for having us.
It's graphic t-shirt day, you guys. Do it for us and for you. we have a comment from YouTube. Let's get into it. Gemma YM, what would you do if there was a squirrel civil war? It's a really good question for you guys in particular.
Yeah. I would love that.
You love it?
I would really love that because I would film it and just make this squirrel. I would cast the squirrels in this like squirrel civil war epic movie.
Yeah.
You would make, and it would be awesome. I'd put it on YouTube.
I feel like, and you wouldn't have to do that much to it, because I feel like they always look so alert that it just, if they were at war, it'd be so dramatic and intense, just naturally.
We'd give them these costumes, you know, North versus South.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
It'd be like a Ken Burns movie.
It would be, it really would be, but also kind of like a Pixar.
Yeah.
But real.
But like super violent.
And like that famous video with the squirrel, that's, you know that one?
Yeah.
So it'd be like that over and over and over again, but they'd have little guns.
Yeah.
Bayonets at the end.
Oh my gosh, let's make this happen, you guys, together. Okay, next comment from YouTube is from Vanessa Gregor. Favorite cartoon anime movies?
WALL-E.
Yes.
Yeah.
For some reason, it took a long time to like register that in my brain, and I was picturing Free Willy, and I was like, and I was waiting for the joke about like why, and I was like, and then explain, and then my brain translated what you said, and I agree, yeah.
I like The Simpsons, so Simpsons movies are pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that too. Yeah. I mean, like, old school Beauty and the Beast, Little Mermaid are not anime, and I understand, but
yeah,
cartoon was an option too, right?
Yeah.
Okay, next comment is from Header Suck. What is the donkey in the background's name?
Patrick. Patrick, National Film Society.
Check us out, we're on YouTube.
Yeah.
Hi.
your hair is incredible.
Thanks.
Can I touch it?
Yeah.
It goes all the way in there.
Yeah, totally. I hide stuff in there.
I thought maybe there was like another hair underneath it.
There is.
It's just more of your hair.
Yeah.
Checking. Yep. True to the scalp.
Yep, all the way.
It's true to the scalp, all the way, guys. Next comment is from Michael Corvin 79. It's extremely important that you, that you ask Patrick for me what is the secret to his hair and mustache are. What the secret to his hair and mustache are?
Pearl cream. Right? It helped it grow.
Doesn't pearl cream?
Yeah. That's the stuff, right?
Like you put it on pearls?
80s and 90s? Nope.
To make pearls shiny?
Yeah, it helps like hair growth.
Oh.
I recommend it to everyone.
You try to actually grow more hair?
Yeah.
Wow. You're going to overwhelm us all.
Yeah. Not working here so well.
It's good. It's better that it's not. I like that it's like super fresh and clean over here and that it's just coming in strong. In the right spots. It's amazing.
I'm
really impressive up close, you guys.
I'm proud.
You should be. This is a lot. Next comment is from Ardeca18. If you could be any animal, what would you be and why?
Squirrel, so I can be in the Civil War.
And then film stars.
Yeah.
Like, that's a package deal.
Done,
So it's pretty, what about you? It's still a hard life, though. It's short, probably, I imagine.
Yeah, but, you know, you gotta be a multi-hyphenate for a while, you know? You can do, like, acting, comedy, action.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't know. I really don't know.
I'm gonna answer.
Can't answer.
Like
this question.
Like a sea animal, or would you like to fly?
I thought about.
Would you like to be a house
I thought
pet?
About like a blue whale because you'd be the biggest, right? Like huge.
That's immediately where I went too.
Yeah.
Whales on the brain, you guys. I think I'd like to be an octopus because they're really smart, and I'm really afraid of them.
Okay. And they're chewy.
Oh God, I hate them so much. They're so scary. Just
are they delicious? Do you think they're delicious?
The fact that people put them in their mouths is so bizarre to me, but I would be one, and then I would get over that fear, and I would go around and scare people. Because I'd be super smart.
Would you ever? How would you react if somebody had like an octopus costume for Halloween?
I literally could not see. Not that I'm dying to, but I can't see the second Pirates of the Caribbean movie because of the octopus face. Don't do that to me. Don't do that. Next comment. We're moving on. Is Oishi Media National Film Society rules?
Yes.
I just said it.
Yeah. Totally. Thanks.
He usually will only comment with maybe one or two exclamation points marks.
That's what you get when you're on live internet.
Yeah.
You get multiple. It's like you can't contain the. That's what happens live.
Yeah, it's great.
Okay, another comment. Let's check it out. CJ Hulk, favorite sport to watch? We were just had a big football conversation before the show.
Niners football.
Because I'm a Packers fan, and my second team is the Lions, and the Niners just killed us two weeks in a row. I'm just
sorry for him and you.
If your facial hair wasn't so fantastic, I'd be not giving you eye contact as often.
What can you do?
Grow perfect facial hair. But what sport do you like to watch?
Basketball. Love it.
Do you have a team?
Clippers. LA Clippers, they're the other team in Los Angeles.
There. Right. People go to people.
Some people
so I suppose
have
that's easier
them.
To get tickets.
It is, but they have been selling out with Chris Paul and last season. So, Clippers, watch out. We're going to take the Lakers and play them. Our best abilities.
Do they play each other?
Yeah, they play all the time. And apparently, everybody who goes to the Clippers Lakers games, even if it's the Clippers games, is a Laker fan.
Yeah. Except for you, that's a great way to like make sure that you can be a number one fan is to pick a team that the other team in town is just way more popular.
Exactly.
Yeah. Cool. I like watching basketball too. I like men's shoulders, as we all know. Next comment is from Donut Nazi. If you could have everyone likes these kinds of questions. If you could have anyone play you in a movie, who would it be and why? These are good questions, you guys. Thanks.
As a matter of fact, we did a video. Mm-hmm. You can check it on our channel. It's called La Bamba, Greatest Movie Ever. And La Bamba's a movie from the 80s. It's about Ritchie Valens, who's a musician. It's played by Lou Diamond Phillips in the lead role. And his supporting character was the role of Bob, who was his brother, played by...
Isai Morales.
So we say La Bamba is the greatest movie ever because not only does it tell our story, but we actually look like Lou Diamond Phillips and Isai Morales.
So you've got it. Except that movie is not the best ending.
But you just stop before the end.
Gotcha. Because you're still living, so.
We want to do La Bamba 2. Mm-hmm. So basically, it'll start with Bob telling Richie not to get on the plane.
Yeah.
And then we end up in present day.
I love it.
La Bamba 2.
Do that. You guys have the power.
Help us.
And the talent. Yeah. You can help them do that. We have another comment from YouTube, and that is from Chester Rowley. How would I be able to make a good stop-motion movie? Can't believe you didn't ask me that when it was just me hosting. I'll let you guys answer.
I don't know anything.
You go like this, right? You're like, you do this, and then you film it, and then you go like this, and then you film it, and then you go like this, and you film it.
And you have a walking bracelet.
Yeah. And that's a film.
And there's like, you know, with DSLR technology, you can make stuff, you can kind of get the settings right, so you just basically, it fires off like a few clicks, and then you just move whatever pieces you're having move, and put it all into some editing software, and it just works. So
I'm sure do that.
There's tutorials on YouTube and stuff.
I have no patience. I'd be like, do it once, I'd get it all set up, and then I'd be like, let's just do it. Make a move, let's go.
It takes hours and hours, and maybe days.
I'm all stressed out, just think about that. Makes me want to eat candy. Next comment is from the Thai Wanderer. The Kickstarter project is running concurrent to the CAM funding contest. How is that going? What's the CAM? CAM.
CAM is the Center for Asian American Media.
In San Francisco.
And so we applied for funding from them. And we don't know if we're going to get it. But we also launched a Kickstarter last week for our new web series, Awesome Asian Bad Guys. Sort of about Asian bad guys from the 80s and 90s who would be in action movies and then basically they would be fighting the hero and then they would die. And so
we're bringing them back to life.
We want to take these guys, put them together with us into this web series. And
the actors who play those roles?
Exactly.
Yes.
Like the guy with like the Fu Manchu.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
The guy from Karate Kid 2.
This is a wonderful idea.
It's like the Expendables meets Dumb and Dumber.
It's so good. So you have a Kickstarter out for that you just started?
We do. So we launched last Tuesday. We have an ambitious goal, but we were recently a Kickstarter staff pick and have been getting some good traction. So check it out. You can get this t-shirt. It's one of the rewards. Awesome Asian Bad Guys.
Yes, I know that if you go to their website, their YouTube channel, that's the first video is like you guys launching a Kickstarter campaign.
Exactly.
So that's our show, you guys. Thank you so much for being here. Patrick and Steven. Check out their channel and subscribe. And then watch their Kickstarter video and help them out there. And subscribe to us too, for goodness sake. And Grace will be here tomorrow. And on Wednesday, we're celebrating Talk Like a Pirate Day. because that's what Wednesday is. Not till Wednesday, you guys save it. Because the whole day it has to happen. Mm. And Baratunde Thurston is going to be here. Thanks again for being here. This was really fun. I'll see you guys later. You're my favorite.